come. Give yourselves to my scouring winds that I may feast upon your essence.
Thank you. Thank you.
There's still time. With more of the dragon's ether, I can yet... You're finished.
I see you've bested Barbariccia. Well done.
Her minions too are all crystallized or scattered. The day is ours.
What of my sister? Tell me you learned something about Ashdaya. So the Archfiend and her crystal yielded not.
Our efforts have not been entirely fruitless. We have deprived your sister's captor of another powerful champion. With Zero, we may yet challenge Golbez and his minions.
Indeed. We could not have come this far without your aid. Thank you, Zero.
I but fulfilled my part of the bargain. And now I will have my...
Her ether is nearly spent. Perhaps unsurprising given how much power she used.
I wouldn't want to face another Archfiend without her. We should hurry back to Zero's domain.
Agreed. Eager though I am to continue, it would be unwise to risk our lives for the sake of haste. Let us suspend the mission and tend to Zero.
You're all safe. Thank the sisters.
A moment while I close the gate. There. We may rest easy for now. Was there any trouble? I expect some void sense slipped through.
A few did, aye. But we were ready and dealt with them without incident.
That is well. I cannot thank you enough for your vigilance.
Yes, yes, you're grateful. But aren't you forgetting something more important? You know, the polite but warm formalities one delights in hearing when their little brother returns from a long journey.
Indeed, you are right. It is good to be home again, among those who I love dearly and missed so much.
And we are glad to receive you, Vashan. Welcome home!
Chambers have been prepared for your use at Megaduta. Let us take Zero there at once. Our mission took many an unexpected turn. I am relieved that we have all returned safely. But before you all enjoy the rest you have earned a dozen times over, I would consult you on one last matter.
Zero.
While she appears none the worse for wear, she remains locked in slumber, and I cannot help but worry. Is there aught we can do to expedite her recovery? If her ether is exhausted, perhaps I can share some of mine now.
In the wastelands of the 13th, one can only replenish ether by taking it from others, be it by trade or by force. In contrast, the source is rich in ambient ether. Simply being here and drawing breath, Zero will absorb what she needs.
Then we need but wait?
I believe so. She will awaken in time, and when she does, give her something to eat. Judging by her form, she should also be able to derive nourishment from food. I know you promised her your ether, but perhaps she might appreciate fine Harnish cuisine more.
Food can certainly be arranged.
She looks like any other person. Unsurprising, perhaps, given that she is only part Voidscent.
Zero said before that Xenos had altered her essence. A change wrought, I suspect, with the power of darkness. It acted upon the part of her that is Voidscent, rendering it dominant. Thus, we were able to reverse it with the power of light. I labor to believe that Xenos possessed such arcane knowledge. In all likelihood, it came from Fandaniel. Were Zero wholly Voidscent, I doubt the crystal would have had an effect on her. One might say that Hydaelyn had a hand in your meeting.
It is no exaggeration to say that Zero has proven herself invaluable, a boon from Hydaelyn herself. Her cooperation may come at a price, but whatever it is, I am willing to pay it, exhausting though it may be at times.
Thank you.
Light. Is this an inn? What happened? How did I get here? There's no time. I must rejoin the battle. I must...
You're awake! Wonderful! What is this? Some sort of fiend? A fiend? Where is it? Where? Ugh, but this is no time for jokes. You're in the source, my dear. The world next door, so to speak. The others brought you here after you collapsed. I'll fetch them at once. Wait, just a moment.
I took the liberty of arranging refreshments. I hope you find them as flavorful as they are invigorating.
This isn't what you promised. I suppose ether is ether.
Wait, wait. Don't tell me you don't know how to eat?
I took what I needed from it. What's the problem?
Where's the enjoyment in that? You're supposed to bite, to chew, to savor, and then swallow. That's the way. So, did it taste good?
I don't know.
The long years without eating may have dulled your sense of taste.
Well, we void scent have no need for such when consuming others. There are some who speak of taste when describing the quality and affinity of their prey's ether. But I loathe the act. Taking ether in small amounts like this is one thing, but diluting my essence, diminishing myself, I'd sooner die. And I have died countless times.
You have? But what happens when you do?
Not much. After a while, you return, together with all your expended life force. The important thing is to die where others won't devour you.
Amazing! My peers who study immortality and resurrection would be most interested in this phenomenon.
The question of taste aside, I am glad that you are able to partake of food like us. I dare say it agrees with your personal preferences.
That's true. You can keep giving me the same on a regular basis.
Very well. As my guest, I shall see that you do not want for comfort. And one other thing. We brought you to our world without your consent. And for that, I apologize. If you wish it, we will return you to yours once you have regained your strength.
It's fine. I have no reason to go back. Except for yours, perhaps. You intend to cross over again, I take it.
I do. I have yet to find my sister. I want nothing more than to rush to her aid, to find this Golbez and free her from his clutches, if he still holds her captive.
Though if our recent experience has taught us anything, it is that the 13th is more dangerous than we ever imagined. Caution must be our watchword.
Better late than never. In the short time you spent in our world, you left a trail of chaos in your wake. You managed to return in one piece this time, but don't assume you'll be so lucky the next.
Rest assured, we will make no assumptions and spare no preparation. Speaking of which, while we rest and ready ourselves, I ask that you tell me more about your home. In return, I will tell you about ours. I will show you my domain, Radzethan.
Again, a stranger in this strange land. I have a condition. You must come too.
You have my thanks.
So, what are your impressions of Radzathan?
There's a lot of mortals.
Considering your origin, I can see why that might be your first observation. Though they would call each other people, I think. If you wish to know about our fair city, I should be glad to place a guide at your disposal.
No need. I'll show myself around. There's only so much about my home I can share with you in return, after all. While I remember some few tales of the past, I cannot speak to their authenticity. But if that is enough, then I will tell you of the events that saw darkness engulf our world. The Contra Memoria.
We are all ears. Please.
Long ago, light filled the world and all was at peace. But then the servants of darkness came, and they bequeathed a black art unto men. Channeling the power of hope and prayer, one could call forth fearsome beings known as Eidolons.
The Ascians. And these Eidolons are surely primals.
Then you have faced the same, and understand that when an Eidolon is birthed, strife follows. And in such strife, the weak are the first to suffer. When it seemed the world would be plunged into chaos, heroes appeared. They who were blessed with a singular power. The power to bind the ether of Eidolons within crystals known as Memoria. My mother was one such Memoriate. But in fighting to save many, she herself was touched by darkness. As was I.
And so you were born part Void Sent, before the world was overcome.
How exactly did that calamity come to pass? Did the Memoriates not triumph?
They did. They expunged the seeds of chaos and restored the peace, only to find themselves seduced by the darkness they had sealed. They spread the taint, transforming men into monsters, what you call Void Sent, and raised armies to wage new wars.
Not the first to be corrupted by power, nor the last.
Some defied temptation and held fast to the light. My mother and I among them. For years and years we fought, but it was not enough. And when our strength was spent, our bulwarks broken, so too was the world.
The Flood of Darkness.
The stars faded from the heavens as a pall black as pitch enveloped creation. Darkness raged unchecked, rending the very walls of reality. I was cast into the rift, and there trapped for what felt like an eternity. Until I came upon a crack. Tiny, infinitesimal, but enough for me to squeeze through. And find my world changed beyond recognition, into the lightless waste you saw.
So that is how you were able to escape becoming a Void Sent in full.
I suppose I should consider myself fortunate. Were I like most others, I wouldn't have lasted a day before being devoured. We, the lost, are better equipped to survive in a lost world.
A lost world, you say? I wouldn't be so sure. The 13th is still there, is it not?
What are you getting at?
To explain requires that we initiate you into the truth of the Source and its reflections. Be warned that this will take a while.
Then, unlike the worlds that have been rejoined, mine still.
The Oracle of Light prevented the first from being completely overcome. So the situation may not be completely identical to that of your 13th. But the fact remains that we were able to restore a measure of balance to a world brought to the brink of destruction. After which, some intrepid young souls succeeded in restoring life back to lands thought lost to light. Which gives me cause to hope the day may yet come when life springs forth anew in the 13th. Of course, these are only possibilities. I offer no guarantees. But having experienced what we have, I dare say we are more qualified than most to speak on the matter.
Wait, I don't understand. Why would you say these things? As if you mean to. But the sole reason you came to the Void was...
To find a dragon, aye. And in light of what we've seen, we'd be fools to strive for more. But we Scions... Former Scions, begging your pardon, have a habit of not leaving well enough alone. And old habits die hard, don't they, my friend?
Restoring the light would serve our efforts to find and free Ashdaya. There is no reason not to try.
Do as you will. I have no desire to save that world.
Be that as it may, we will have need of your power when next we face Voidscent.
You know how it works. If you want my help, you must pay my price. And now that you've drawn Golbez's attention, it's going to cost you more. A lot more. I will consider this a deposit.
first Scarmiglione, and now Barbariccia. Useless, the both of them.
It was no lie. They conspire with a Mamoriad.
And their search for the dragon will lead them here. The war looms nigh. We cannot allow these interlopers to interfere.
If I may, my lord, I have a plan to eliminate them. In order to guarantee success, however, I will require Cagnetto's cooperation.
Now there's sport to be had, then I'll play along. As much as I dislike following your lead, I have no patience for screaming.
Well and good to have confidence, but do not forget the cost of failure.
Rest assured, I will see the dream to fruition. Even should I be consumed by my own flames, I will pave the way for one and all.
Then I will trust in your oath and your plan.
We will give you cause to rejoice, my lord. This I vow.
Ha ha! Some excitement for a change.
Sacrifice is too great. Even should my four archfiends be lost, I will not halt my steps. The prison of passivity is an obstacle to my cause, and so you must fall. What irony that the blessed damned should set us free. As I swore so long ago. Open. At long last, my ambition shall be fulfilled!
We'll be right back. Thank you. Thank you.